Welcome to ChemHelp ASAP. Now, when you discuss valence electrons, you won't get too far into the discussion before you encounter a topic called effective nuclear charge. Effective nuclear charge, I'm going to define this, and that's capital Z and then subscript EFF. This is the net positive charge attracting electrons. And it's assumed that that's going to be within an atom, and it's attracting these electrons to the nucleus. So, as it turns out, ZF, or effective nuclear charge, is a numerical value, and so we have a formula that can tell us what this number is. The formula is Z minus S. So, Z is equal to the number of protons in your atom. Now, that's also equal to the atomic number. So if you know the atomic number, you know how many protons are also in the nucleus. S is equal to what we call the shielding electrons. Shielding electrons are simply the non-valence electrons. So let's go to the bottom left of the screen. Remember our picture of the atom. We have a nucleus, and our nucleus has protons, and we have different shells, and these shells contain our electrons. We have our valence shell, and then we have our non-valence shells. And some people say that these are our shielding shells. These electrons are shielding the valence electrons from seeing the positive charge in the nucleus. So you can think of this as a theater of sorts. Here's the show is in the nucleus, and these electrons are radiating out from the nucleus. And the more people or electrons that are seated in front of our valence electrons, they block the view a little bit of our valence electrons from seeing what's going on in the nucleus, which is seeing the protons. So they call these shielding electrons. Now, this formula is very nice, back on the right-hand side of the screen, and it works well, but let's break it down a little bit more. So if the atom is neutral, then the number of protons equals the total number of electrons. So our formula becomes, our effective nuclear charge formula is still Z minus S, but we can replace in total electrons minus shielding electrons. Well, the total number of electrons, take away the number of shielding electrons, is simply equal to our valence electrons. And we know how to determine the valence electrons. We just simply look at the group number on the periodic table. So if we know the number of valence electrons we have, we also know the effective nuclear charge. So for example, let's go on our periodic table here, our abbreviated periodic table. Here is carbon. Carbon is in group 4. It has 4 valence electrons. So for carbon, bottom of the screen, effective nuclear charge is going to be equal to 4. Now remember, your group numbers aren't always in these Roman numerals or right up top here. Sometimes they're in these Arabic numbers, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18. So in this case, carbon is in group 14. Well, its effective nuclear charge is not 14, but we just take off that tens place and we get 4, and that is the effective nuclear charge for carbon. Likewise, what's the effective nuclear charge for oxygen? It is in group 6, and so therefore it's 6, or group 16, take off the tens place, we get 6. So if we're comfortable with working with our periodic table, we can very quickly determine not only the number of valence electrons, but also the effective nuclear charge of the atom. And the effective nuclear charge has all kinds of consequences. It determines things like ionization energies. It affects the size of the atom. It affects the electronegativity. So these are all important ideas that come from valence electrons and effective nuclear charge.